Hey, what up, y'all? This is 85 here, and welcome back. Got another video for you guys, and today is a special one. Gearbox has officially announced a new Borderlands game. You may or may not have heard about this, but for a while now, there have been some hints that they were working on something other than Borderlands 3 and other than the Telltale games. And the past couple days, different websites have been leaking different things, and I was a little skeptical about it. I'm sure a lot of you guys were as well, but Gearbox actually have posted gameplay on their YouTube channel and on their official Twitter. They have, announced it. It is going to be called Borderlands the Pre-Sequel. It will be out on Xbox 360, PS3, and PC. I'm not really sure what to think about it not being on the next-gen consoles, but considering that they've probably been working on this for a little while now, possibly before the next-gens have came out, I'm not really sure, but I'm accepting it. I've been playing on PC, that's fine, and just save Borderlands 3 for the next-gen. That's my opinion. It's gonna work, and I'm definitely excited for this, and it's gonna be, like I said, it's Borderlands Pre-sequel. That's the name of the game. It's going to be taking place before Borderlands 2, but after Borderlands 1. So in between the both of them, kind of as Handsome Jack was up and coming, it's going to take place on the moon, where we've been wanting to go forever now. So this is awesome. We're going to be going to the Hyperion moon base, and we're going to have four new playable characters. And this is pretty cool. It's going to be different. And honestly, I don't know what to expect. You're going to be able to play as Nisha, Claptrap, Athena, or Wilhelm, and each of these guys are going to have new special abilities, I assume. By the looks of it, there's some sort of ground pound, there's some sort of like axe or something that's being thrown, kind of like a frisbee. I don't know, I'll kind of break it down a little bit later in another video, but it's really awesome, and I just wanted to let you guys know about it. On the moon, and you'll be able to do double jumps and drifting along in the moon and with the gravity. Just amazingness. It's going to be awesome, and I cannot wait for this. I do not believe there is an actual release date for it. Maybe we'll hear more in the next couple days with E3 coming up. But yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know. Go ahead and check out the trailer. Let me know in the comments, what are your thoughts on this? Will you be getting it? I know I am. What character are you going to play as? You're going to play as Athena, Nisha, Claptrap, or Wilhelm? I'm kind of leaning towards either Wilhelm or Claptrap. They look pretty cool. I might actually do Claptrap. Obviously, do them all, but which one do you think you're going to start off as? Let me know in the comments. I'm really excited for this, so I just wanted to let you guys know again. Thanks for watching. See ya.
Warning, no atmosphere detected.
Borderlands the Pre-Sequel is about Handsome Jack's rise to power. It's a sequel to Borderlands 1 and a prequel to Borderlands 2. It's an all-new, full, standalone experience. You're on Handsome Jack's team. You're going to follow him in his rise to power. When we finished Borderlands 2 and as we dove into the DLC for it, we really had so much more we wanted to bring to the Borderlands universe. That's why it was so exciting to discover that the team down in 2K Australia was available.
We talked to their designers talk to our designers. The design team is pretty much one design team, and that catered out over to every discipline, whether that be narrative, whether that be design, programming, art, it's all fairly much intertwined now.
Everything that they bring to the table, everything that 2K Australia invents and adds to Borderlands is a surprise. I also am consuming all this stuff like a fan for the first time, and it's been a real treat.
We've got four new character classes for Borderlands for a sequel. The first one being Nisha, the Lawbringer. We have Athena, the Gladiator. We also have Wilhelm. Now, Wilhelm was from Borderlands 2 as well. And one of the ones that we're really excited about is bringing Claptrap as a playable character for the first time.
One of the coolest things about Borderlands the Pre-Sequel is because it's built as a starting point from the Borderlands 2 technology, it has all of the advantages and all of the features and all of the capabilities of that game. And with the new environments bringing low gravity and no atmosphere, there's a tremendous opportunity for new gameplay that the 2K Australia guys have just blown me away with.
We've invented things like low oxygen because it doesn't have an atmosphere, so what can you do with some mechanics with oxygen? So we haven't just made it a resource, we've made it into a strategy.
Yeah, when I first realized that I could use the oxygen tanks as a jetpack and have longer jumps, have double jumps. I can hover, I can fly. I mean, it just added a whole new loop. And then when I'm up there, they added this new feature. I call it a ground pound. I don't even know if it has an official name, but basically when you're flying, when you're hovering, when you're midair, you hit the crouch button. Bam, you just smash straight to the ground, leave an impact, stun everybody. It's so much fun. Borderlands, the pre-sequel, is going to come later in 2014. It's going to come to the Xbox 360, the PlayStation 3, and Windows PC. It's a great time to jump in and check out what all the fuss is about.